straight from the soul, would it? Yeah. Well, well, well. Everybody hates Patrick Beverly until he's on your team. Okay, so it's been heavily reported that LeBron James would welcome Patrick Beverly to the Lakers if he is perhaps bought out by the Minnesota Timberwolves and he becomes a free agent after he had been traded by the Los Angeles Clippers. You know, I think that the Memphis Grizzlies would have been a much better fit for Patrick Beverly, considering that they had the young budding star, the young rising star, Ja Morant, and they're a playoff team. You know, they could use a veteran like Patrick Beverly. The Timberwolves is just trash. The entire team is just trash to me. You know, Karl Anthony Towns, he's big, but he's soft. He's tall, he's a big guy, but he's soft. Now, it was rumored by Carcino with Carcino for Life, shout out to Carcino, that ever since Patrick Beverly pushed Chris Paul, who was formerly the president of the Players Association, now he's been replaced by, I believe, CJ McCollum. But Patrick Beverly pushed him in the back during the playoffs, and Chris Paul was acting all dramatic, as if he got shot in the back with a shotgun like Ricky from Off of Boys in the Hood, okay? Now, Patrick Beverly is said to not be liked as much now because of that, you know, that altercation. Now, it's obvious that the emotions were high during that game and they were, you know, getting into a back and forth exchange in words or whatnot. But it's just so funny because when we speak about loyalty, right? LeBron James, Carmelo Anthony, and Chris Paul are all supposed to be a part of the banana boat with a strawberry on top, ice cream, banana boat, whatever you want to call it. Yet there seems to be disloyalty here in this situation by welcoming a guy in, Patrick Beverly, who pushed your best friend in the back. Okay? Now I know you want to separate personal from business, but at the same time, I mean, where's the integrity? Where's the loyalty at? Okay. Now, do I believe that Patrick Beverly would be a great addition to the Lakers? Absolutely. I'm a huge fan of Patrick Beverly. You know, I've always liked Patrick Beverly as a player, but the fake stuff, you gotta quit. Stop the fakeness, okay? Patrick Beverly is a really good player. He's extremely tough, aggressive, competitive, and he's an extremely great defender, in my opinion. But I also find it funny how in one breath, Russell Westbrook claims that Patrick Beverly supposedly tricks y'all, and his words, tricks y'all into thinking he's playing defense, but somehow they'll be open to a guy who Russell Westbrook said himself doesn't believe can play defense whatsoever. Y'all would welcome the same guy to the team. But anyway, it doesn't seem like they're all on the same page. But honestly, in my opinion, I think the Lakers should really aggressively pursue Darren Collison. I think he'd be a better fit. I think that's the better decision for the entire team and the organization as a whole. And I just think that he's a better fit with the Lakers, with LeBron and their style and direction that they're trying to go. You know, he's just a better fit than Patrick Beverly, just based on his ability to be able, you know, to be able to create shots off the dribble. He's a really solid defender. So in other words, everything that you get from Patrick Beverly or Isaiah Thomas, I think that Darren Collison will offer you that and more. You know, he's a lot more composed, but he has an edge just from a basketball perspective. It just makes sense. He's more composed, but he also has an edge. But anyway, y'all let me know what y'all think. Do y'all think the Lakers should sign Patrick Beverly if he's bought out, or do y'all think that they should just go in a different direction? Y'all let me know what y'all think. Y'all get in that comment box, like, share, subscribe. I'm out.